Hello, let's listen to the investigation by the New York City Department of Investigation into the campaign for One New York de Blasio nonprofit. Let's listen to the closing memorandum. Very hard to find, but this has been translated or optically read because they publish a PDF that was highly redacted and just images of pages, not the real text.
The City of New York Department of Investigation. 2. File. Date, October 22, 2018. From Carolyn Tomsu, re. CMS number 1603782. Closing memorandum. The following is a summary only of the information pertaining to this investigation and does not contain each and every fact learned during the course of the investigation. Origin and nature of allegation. Apartment. On April 13, 2016, the New York City Department of Investigation, DOI, received concerning Mayor Bill de Blasio and the campaign for One New York CONI, a not-for-profit organization formerly associated with the mayor, indicated that CONI may have received donations from various entities and individuals with business before the city, some of which were given at or around the time the donor was seeking a particular contract or approval. Also noted that CONI appeared to have made payments to consulting firms that work for Mayor de Blasio in other capacities and are paid by his election campaign fund. Focused primarily on two areas. One, the mayor's fundraising efforts on behalf of CONI. Whether Mayor de Blasio or any employee of the office of the mayor solicited contributions from any individual who had or whose organization had a matter pending or about to be pending before any executive branch of the city. In violation of City Charter 88-2604-B-2, COIB Advisory Opinion 2003-4, and COIB Advisory Opinion 2008-6, and IDOI Commissioner Mark Peters was recused from the investigation of this matter. Page 1 of 15, DOIS Investigation. DOI's investigation included, among other steps, 1. Conducting dozens of witness interviews, including of CONI donors, attorneys and lobbyists who participated in fundraising for CONI, consultants who were compensated by CONI, either directly or through the firms, 4 former members of CONY's board of directors, Mayor Bill de Blasio. 2. Issuing subpoenas to and reviewing records from CONI and major consultants to CONI, including Skinnickerbocker, SKDK, Greenberg, Quinlan, Rossner Research, GQRR, AKPD Message and Media, AKPD, Berlin Rosen and Hilltop Public Solutions, Hilltop, and 3. Performing research to identify CONI donors who had or were likely to have a matter pending or about to be pending before one or more executive branch offices or agencies of the city. Results of investigation. CONI registered as a not-for-profit corporation in New York State on December 12, 2013. The organization began receiving donations in January 2014 and raised a total of approximately $4 million during its existence. CONI was disbanded around March 2016, though it was originally established to support Mayor de Blasio's Universal Pre-Kindergarten, UPK, campaign. It later supported a broad array of Mayor de Blasio's policy objectives, paying for numerous NFT, ET, plus specifically at Skinnickerbocker Media, at Berlin Rosen, at Hilltop Public Solutions, at AKPD Message and at Hilltop Public Solutions. Page 2 of 15. Consultants who advised City Hall on political strategy, communications, and messaging related to a wide variety of issues facing the mayor. A. CONY's operations. 1. CONY's legislative and political objectives. According to CONI fundraising materials, CONI began with a single focus to develop a grassroots campaign to build support for Mayor de Blasio's plan for free full day UPK in New York City. During the UPK campaign, CONI operated and received donations under the name UPK NYC after the success of the UPK campaign in March 2014. CONY's mission became a more generalized effort to support Mayor de Blasio's overall agenda. The next major campaign CONY supported was the Progressive Agenda to Combat Income Equality, TPA. In 2015, CONY provided financial support to Mayor de Blasio's affordable housing agenda. Though CONY's work on the housing agenda slowed by the summer of 2015. In addition to these larger campaigns, CONY supported a wide variety of Mayor de Blasio's policy objectives. CONY paid several consultants for strategy and communications advice on topics and issues that he encountered as mayor, including education issues, homelessness, and the preservation of Long Island College Hospital. 2. Roles of and Mayor de Blasio of Berlin. Rosen described of Hilltop Public Solutions as the CEO of CONY, and indicated that was involved in making all of CONY's significant decisions. Told DOI that selected the consultants retained by CONY, negotiated most consulting agreements on behalf of CONY, and was responsible for approving CONY's expenditures. Stated that selected CONY's consultants because they had existing relationships with the mayor. Served as CONY's sole employee from January 2014 until approximately April 2016. S official title was, and, that had no other role or responsibilities beyond raising funds for the organization. CONY also paid several consultants who essentially functioned as part-time CONY employees. Mayor de Blasio does not appear to have participated in the day-to-day management of CONY, but he influenced the organization's strategy and benefited from CONY's relationships with several consultants who advised him on a range of matters. Mayor de Blasio was also involved in raising funds on CONY's behalf and told DOI that they did not know or could not remember whether Mayor de Blasio was directly involved in creating CONY. Mayor de Blasio did not recall who initially had the idea to create CONY and stated that he had agreed to CONY's creation only if COIB approved it. Stated that selected the consultants to be paid by CONY, but did not specifically discuss them with the mayor. Mayor de Blasio confirmed that he had no direct role, page 3 of 15, in choosing CONY's employees or consultants, but it was assumed that CONY would be controlled by the same group of professionals with whom he had worked for years. Told DOI that they primarily communicated with, they assumed that further communicated with the mayor as appropriate. Mayor de Blasio told DOI that he did not need to approve specific expenditures. He explained that he received periodic updates on CONY and was generally satisfied that it was moving in the right direction. For the most part, CONY, through its consultants, worked on and addressed issues as they arose in Mayor de Blasio's administration. Expressed that it was understanding that role as a CONY consultant was intertwined with the mayor's governing of the city. Thus, work for CONY included any request received from City Hall. Attended weekly meetings with the mayor where they discussed political issues in the city, and otherwise had ongoing, consistent communication with another CONY consultants. Told DOI that by the summer of 2015, many of the consultants began to question CONY's effectiveness and considered shuttering operations. Recalled that Mayor de Blasio initially opposed CONY's closure, but later agreed to its dissolution. B. Issue number 1, CONY's fundraising. 1. Background. In 2 advisory opinions from 2003 and 2008, COIB articulated rules for elected officials who are fundraising on behalf of a not-for-profit organization that support the official's mission. In brief, COIB stated that elected officials may use city time and resources to participate in such fundraising. Provided that, 1, the solicitations contain an express statement that a decision whether or not to give will not result in official favor or disfavor, and 2, the official does not solicit any person or firm with a matter pending or about to be pending before the official where it is within his legal authority or duties to make, affect, or direct the outcome of the matter. CCOIB Advisory Opinion No. 2003-4, COIB Advisory Opinion No. 2008-6.
We will continue in the next video.